In today's tutorial, we are talking how to style and edit your photos in order to build your brand and get noticed on Instagram. Hey guys, welcome back. My name's Shada. So as an artist and a YouTuber, I think a lot about presentation, but I don't think I'm alone in that. As artists, we want our voice to be heard, we want our work to be seen, and social media is a great medium for sort of carrying our work out into the world. But I'm speaking from experience, just because you have a beautiful personal body of artistic work, that doesn't always translate into an interesting personal body of Instagram work. And photographing your artwork can just be really tricky. But that's what we're gonna tackle today, and this is not a camera tutorial. This is all stuff you can do with your cell phone, but we're gonna talk lighting, we're gonna talk styling, which I love, and we're also gonna talk editing, which is so important. We're gonna be using PicMonkey, which is a super simple to use in-browser photo editing software, so it's perfect even if you're an absolute beginner and you can try it out today with me. So today's tutorial is really for you if you're a painter or illustrator or hand letterer, but also if you're a knitter or a jewelry maker and you wanna share your voice, your work online, you wanna tell your story visually, and you want to make a big impact on those little squares. So let's get started. Today's tutorial is sponsored by PicMonkey. Sign up through my link within 48 hours to get 3 bonus months on your subscription, but we'll talk more about that later. So let's get our crash course started. The first thing we're gonna talk about is lighting. Lighting is so important. You wanna use natural light when you're photographing. Here you can see, I just turned on the overhead lights and everything gets a little yellowy. Turn them back off and it's quite neutral. Now this isn't terrible because I'm near a window, but look what happens. Those yellowy tones in your home lights, they might be cozy, but they're just plain awful for photographing your work. So what I do is I've got a board here and I just place it on a stool near a window and I can move it around depending how bright it is. So turn off all your overhead lights and shoot near a window. Next, we're gonna talk styling. My favorite, yes. So here I have the board that you just saw and a little hand lettering piece that I made up quickly. And I wanna talk about how to put together a little photo. I like to use something with texture, so maybe some linen or a tea towel like this one with the tassels. I also like things of interest, like different colors of paper or ripped paper, envelopes, and then stationery items add interest, like little clips and washi tape and staples and scissors. Oh my goodness, my scissors. Those are actually an example of a prop that I've used so many times, they've sort of become iconic in my photos. Lots of other people use them as well, but you can sort of style your own style, I guess, by using props over and over again. Of course, I like some flowers too. That's how you begin to cultivate your Instagram look or your social media look, and that goes well beyond your artwork. So let's look at an example of what I'm talking about. We've got linen and ripped paper for texture and color. Here I've used blue paper or a map to create a backdrop for the product or the art. I think, of course, you can just keep it simple, one twig or pen. Again, just a flower or a sprig of eucalyptus. Or you can use many things to create a photo that really tells a story about the art. And let's try this in practice once again. I've got a piece of tissue paper here. It's white, it's simple. All I did was crumple it as a backdrop, and that adds a nice element of texture. Maybe not color, but at least some texture. And then I'm using a tape dispenser and a little stapler and some cute washi tapes. If I use a pen, I often take the lid off it. It's just one more thing, one sort of adds a little movement. I've got some pretty gold paper clips, and because there's gold on the stapler, it adds, you know, I've kind of got a little color theme going here, and then I've decided to add some flowers in. I love, you know, adding flowers into the stationery mix. So those are sort of the things that I like, flowers and stationery goods. And that works, I find. I like it. And here are my photos that I got out of that little staging shoot. And don't be afraid to do more with less. You can always pare it back and get something that works just as well. Especially with the flowers, it can just be as simple as one twig and a little leaf. As long as you've got a bit of color and texture, you're going to be fine.
And you don't always have to shoot from above. Here's an example of a piece I shot a couple different ways. And flat lay might be nice for just capturing the work, but shooting at a different angle can tell a story and really draw your viewer in. So I'm gonna try to do one more styling and then we are going to edit our photos with PicMonkey. PicMonkey is my favorite design and photo editing software. And actually they are releasing an all new PicMonkey to the world this year and I've been trying it out and you guys can try out the new version. And if you'd like to follow along with the tutorial, here's PicMonkey here on my desktop. You can actually get 3 months free. They'll tack on 3 extra months if you sign up using my link in the video description within 48 hours. So if you want to try the new PicMonkey before everyone else and get 3 months for free, definitely click that link in the description. So here's my photo. I've brought it in. You can see a layers palette comes up, which comes in really handy, but we're just going to close it for now. You can always get it back. It's this little layers icon. But let's talk about the PicMonkey interface. It's so easy to use. All of the menus are over on the left here. And the first one is all your basic edits. So the most important stuff, that one's at the top. They're really guiding you through. Next one is more like effects, like cool things you can do, but not as integral. After that, we have touch-ups like airbrushing. You can add text, you can add shapes like hearts and whatever you can think of. But today we're gonna focus on those very basic, but very important edits. So crop and straighten. This is like my mantra, crop and straighten your photos. So here what I'm doing is I've clicked square because it's gonna be for Instagram. And then you can see here the dimensions are changing, but if I click scale photo, it will grab those dimensions that I've set it at and hold them. So about 2000 pixels is great for Instagram. Now I can change the size of the crop and the actual pixel dimension will not change. So I'm not gonna scale my photo way, way down or something accidentally. So just something to keep in mind. I'm just trying to get my crop just right here, just the way I want. And then now I've got a photo that's framed really well. Click there to fit it back into the window, fit to window. And then we want to straighten. So we're going through the rotate tool. And here we can straighten our image. If you had a horizon in the image, heck, if you have art in the image and it's not quite the angle you want, crop and straighten, you guys. This is what it's all about. You want strong photos. It's really just about, you know, framing the photo properly, but you can do that in post edit. That's what I'm doing here, and then straighten it. And that's gonna be so professional. Then we go down here and we're using some of our brightening tools. And I always tend to up the brightness a little bit. Bright photos are in, but you might go for a moodier photo. You can see you could take those highlights down, take the shadows up or down. Lowering the shadows like I'm doing here will give you a little more depth and contrast. And then of course the contrast. You don't want to go too hard with that, especially if there's people in the photo. But if you're photographing art, and that's what we're doing here, you can up that contrast up into, you know, 10, 20, because you want high contrast. You want your art to pop. So these are just our very basic edits. And next thing we're gonna do is go down to color. And here you can up your saturation. Maybe you want your look to be very overly saturated or maybe a little faded. I tend to go just under. And then we have the temperature slider. So all of these decisions are so important to cultivating your online brand. Do you want to be warm and peachy? Are you sort of that beachy and you love pink tones? Or do you want to be that dark and moody? Do you like those cool, icy tones? So thinking about these things, that's really going to help you cultivate an Instagram or social media presence that's curated and that says something about you. So not just your art talking for you, but also the look of your photos. Okay, so all I have to do now is save that, and I'm just gonna go up here and basically download it onto my computer, but PicMonkey also conveniently keeps all of your work in the hub, so you can always come back and edit projects. It's not like some browser software where then it's gone once you navigate away. So let's do another one and let's go over those basics. First thing we're gonna do, crop. Let's go to square, make sure we don't scale it down too far. We can, you know, scale photo if we need to. Right now, I'm just thinking about framing this image so that it's most effective. Not everything has to be centered. I love using lots of negative space, so lots of white space or blank space. I think that looks great. And then, of course, we can think about straightening if it needs it, but I don't think this one does need that. So let's go right down to exposure and up our brightness and do all those little things that make such a big difference, those little edits. So I like to up the brightness. And then for this one, I'm doing something different. I'm taking the highlight slider way down so that I get this kind of grayed out image. Still gonna up the contrast a little and take the shadows down so that there is some contrast, but I want that highlight slider way to the left so that I get this gray image where the brights are not washed out at all. And this is sort of a fun, I think kind of hipstery look that you see on Instagram and even on websites now. And that's just something that's such a simple edit, but it has a big impact, and you could do that to all your photos. And then that's your sort of your style online. So something to think about. You can play around with these different edits, these very simple edits, and you can create a really cohesive, unique style that's all yours. Get the photo on my computer, I just click that little arrow at the top, and then of course you can name your project whatever, save it as a JPEG or a PNG and use it on your social media. Now, of course, you can use PicMonkey for adding all kinds of cool shapes and text, and we're gonna get even more into that I'm gonna do a follow-up tutorial to this one. I wanna talk to you guys about creating Instagram stories that have really cool fonts on them and that kind of stuff. But I hope that this little crash course sort of in styling, lighting, editing has you inspired and feeling like this is something you can do and it isn't scary. It's just about turn those overhead lights off because they are orange, and try the all new PicMonkey. Just click that link in the description, sign up within 48 hours. They'll add on an additional 3 months. And then this link in the description gets you access to the beta. So register with that. And then to take advantage of the offer, you have to go to picmonkey.com from your desktop to subscribe. So try it out, follow along with the tutorial, and then next time we're gonna go even farther. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to subscribe.